Those stowed away paintings came to the attention of an art dealer named Debbie Murray.
The moment that I looked at the art, the hair on my arm stood up. I just stopped cold and I said, my God, this is not an artist. This is a genius.
She knew immediately she had come across two rare finds, the paintings and the painter. But a struggle ensued. In order to show and sell the work, Debbie Murray first had to pry it from the hands of a somewhat unwilling artist.
I took the paintings back and didn't want to sell them. So you have to sell because you have to make a living.
Eventually, the partnership took hold, and in 1988, Debbie Murray and Yuri Gevorgyan formed Stygian Publishing.
You have to go through the darkness to get to paradise.
Stygian refers to the darkness and gloom that make up the fiery river Styx in Greek mythology, the river that surrounds Hades. There's an irony in associating something so hellish with work so heavenly, but listen to the concept behind it, and quickly you understand.
You have to go through the darkness to get to paradise.
Yuroz begins each of his works on black paper or black canvas.
I'm painting black because I really feel that the dark background painting, the canvas, gives the artist more chance to see exactly the light he puts on the dark surface. With white canvas, you always ask any artist, they have to cover the whole painting, whole canvas, then see what's going on in the painting.
Come to my window. Crawl inside, wait by the light of the moon. Come to my window, I'll be home soon.
The result is sometimes intensely overwhelming. One can only stand and stare and be swept away in the candid, personal, impassioned, and often romantic swirls of color.
I love romance, and I think life without romance would be like everything without color.
May I touch your music?
He paints tender, small human emotions, the things that really make our life important.
But I loved you.
But he paints the less than tender too, the stark, naked truth of humanity, beautiful, graphic portrayals of real life, and its erotic combination of loneliness and lust. Once you are familiar with a Yuroz canvas, you become intrigued by the subtleties. The blue rose that symbolizes healing after a struggle, and the pomegranate, a symbol of fertility, and for the artist, much more.
Where I come from, Armenia, we have places, it's very rocky, you know, very dry rocky mountains. There is no grass, there is nothing like alive anything. And suddenly from these rocky mountains, you can see these very abstract, like trees are coming out. And those are pomegranate trees, and these very pinkish red pomegranate fruits. And when you eat those pomegranates, they're the most juiciest thing in the world, I'm telling you. And you can't believe, you know, you look around, you say, you know, this dry, dead environment, how this tree can produce such a wonderful fruit. And I just took that symbol for me like it was survival, symbol of survival.
His gallery is located in downtown Los Angeles, but Yuroz travels the world to show his work. One of his personal favorites is the annual Art Expo in New York City. In this unusual gesture that best portrays the kindness and generosity he gives to those who seek him out, Yuroz draws on the very clothing his admirers are wearing.
Make you ticklish, let me know, okay? Hard work, someone has to do it.
The wait is sometimes very long. The work is surely tedious. The results, though, a Yuroz original. And the cost, only one's patience.
Bravo.
Okay.
Bravo.
There are so many people there hungry for art, something beautiful. And I look at it this way, it's like two-way street. They give me inspiration, I give them what they want, I just let them schedule something that makes them happy.
Both artist and entrepreneur, a Yuroz painting can now be found indelibly fired into bold works of ceramic art. And Eurozone, a design firm, is on the horizon. Limited edition vests, jackets, and jewelry have already been introduced. Yuroz is a man who works on his own terms.
No matter what, it's important even a piece of t-shirt can intrigue and give you some kind of emotional impact. In the meantime, if I have a chance in any way, in any form, to bring that part of art to you, even if it's napkin, I'm going to do napkin. I don't care what they said. If I am going to be able to do very good quality t-shirt, that you can wear the t-shirt and you will be happy with that piece of fabric covers you, and even just the look, the way it looks, I'm going to do it. Nobody's going to stop me. That's why I'm in this country.
In 1992, Yuri Gevorgyan became an American citizen.
I saw the flag, and suddenly, for that couple minutes, and I remembered all this 14 years of what a struggle and 7, 8 years here. So it's like 1 second, whole film goes through your mind, and it's like a dream. It's really a dream.
Since then, the struggle has been less urgent, but the life-fulfilling quest still calls.
All I know that there are lots of things going on, and this is what I have, is just the tools to try to make those things come out, because it would be great big crime if I kill this body before I bring all these things out.